Hi everyone, I'm Sarah, one half of the YA Room, and today I'm going to share with you the weirdest books I've read and loved. These are books that are weird either because of the way they're told, or just like what's in the narrative itself, or any other way. So yeah, let's get into that. The first weird book I've read is The Leaving by Tara Altobrando. This book is about six kids that go missing and then they come back to their hometown. And while that isn't like as weird as you may think, the way that this book itself is written is really unique. I mean, look at that. Oh yes. Then you have this kind of stuff going on and that kind of stuff, and it's just like very, very weird. The way this book is written kind of follows the mindset of the characters, and they each have their own like thinking process, so they each have this different kind of way that their story is written. I feel like the way that it's written really helps this novel, helps get the story across to the reader, and it's just so unique and unlike anything I've ever read before. This book is weird and I like it. Next up I have Never Night by Jay Kristoff, and for those of you that have read this book, you'll know that this is a weird one. Seriously, like, would we expect any less from Jay? I think not. Right from the get-go, you're seeing these two alternating chapters that are kind of mirroring each other, but with very different things. Like, one of them is kind of performing this sexual activity, and the other is killing someone. So it's kind of those two polar opposites. Not to mention, there is also like these little notes down the bottom, and there's like numbers and asterisks throughout, and then you kind of read what's at the bottom, and it's just very odd. But I love it. There's also like a cat thing made out of shadows, and there's a lot of murder in this book. The narration style itself is like very, very odd, and I love it. This book honestly is so great. I can't believe I waited until now to pick it up, but I really enjoyed it. The next book I have to share with you is Welcome to Night Vale by Joseph Fink and Jeffrey Craner. I have been obsessed with the Welcome to Night Vale podcast ever since I was in year 9, so I was like 2013-ish, maybe? It was a long time ago, okay? So basically, this is a whole new story that the two creators of the podcast have written together. It is narrated mostly by like the voice of Night Vale, Cecil, who speaks on the radio, and you also get kind of different stories woven throughout. It's so odd, and it's like just so good. I can't even explain it. There's like this kid that can shapeshift, and there's glowing clouds and like five-headed dragons. Welcome to Night Vale is the strangest thing I've ever encountered, and it says a lot about me because I absolutely adore it and I am obsessed with it. Next up I have Brooding YA Hero, which is just such a funny, strange, odd book. If you don't know, Brooding YA Hero is on Twitter. His tweets are hilarious. It's all about kind of like the tropes and what authors write their YA heroes to do. He's like, oh, I have to like be brooding and mysterious to win over the YA heroine. Also, I have a dark past, but it's very alluring. And it's just so funny. This book like turns tropes on its heads. It shows you what has been done in the past and like why that is so funny and hilarious, and it's just such a good book. Broody himself actually narrates this book, and so you have little like tips of what he's done and like different roles he can play, and it's just so good. Basically, he's telling you about his life as a brooding YA hero and how authors like employ him to be their YA hero, and it's just so strange and I love it. The next book I have here is Afterworlds by Scott Westerfeld. This book is told from like two different kind of stories. There's one that follows the life of a teen writer who is getting her book published, and the other who has died and is in this kind of like afterworld place. These stories kind of switch back and forth, and it takes you a while to notice how these two stories interconnect, and it's so strange, and like the stuff that happens is so odd, but it's incredible as well. I love Scott Westerfeld's storytelling. I've loved his Ugly series, and I just love this book as well. So yeah, if you haven't read this book already, it came out a few years ago, but it is definitely worth a read. And finally, the last book I have to share with you is Obsidio by Amy Kaufman and Jay Kristoff. The whole Illuminae series is so odd, but it's so addictive and so amazing. If you don't know, this series is set in space and there's like this murderous artificial intelligence and plagues that are killing everyone and like enemy starships, and it's just so incredible. But one of the other things that makes this book so weird is the fact that it has like different kind of things that are in here, like files, and it has lists, and it has like, oh, just everything you could ever want. I mean, look at that. Look how weird that is. So not only is the story itself very out there, the way this book is written is so strange, but it is incredible and unlike anything I've ever read. And I'm pretty sure I will never read anything like this ever again, just because it is so unique and unlike anything that's ever been done before. If you haven't picked it up yet, please do so. You will not regret it. So yeah, these are my recommendations for weird books that I loved. If you haven't read some of these, I hope you add them to your TBR. And if you have any other weird recommendations, I would love to know. But that is it for today's video. I hope you liked it. Please leave me a comment down below and I will see you soon. Bye everyone!